Hello and welcome to my survival world. My name is Draco. So today I want to do a world tour video because my world is a little bit over 5 years old this month. And yeah, I wanted to show you what I have been doing in those 5 years. So let's start with this little house here. This is a spawn house from my previous world, which I did before those 5 years. And yeah, I made a few changes to it, but it's pretty much the same house. There's almost, yeah, there's no interior. So most of my houses don't have an interior. I think there's only like one, which is the villa over there. Let me go to sleep. So the mobs don't come out, and especially the phantoms. I'm not sure how long it's been since I slept. Okay. Behind here I got a little wolf cave. It's nothing special. Some of my viewers gave them a name. Let's go move on. Over here I got a small house for my horse, which I never use. Anastasia, Accent's daughter, his oldest daughter, gave this horse the name Felix. If I were to ask her now, she probably doesn't even remember that she did, but yeah, that doesn't matter. Let's see, this also doesn't have an interior. No, it doesn't. Yep, okay. Let's see. So we got a little pathway, and yeah, also a mountain that I made, which I will show you in a flyby as well. Once I've shown everything from the ground. I got a villa here. This actually has a little bit of an interior, but yeah, I'm not so good with that stuff, so I barely ever do interiors. Over there I got a samurai helmet house. That house. Let's see, let's move on. Follow the path a little bit. Okay. So over here I got some smaller houses. They aren't that special. Let's see. Yeah, it's not really a lot to see. Oh, that's my dragon statue. I will show that during the flyby as well. Yeah, they don't have an interior. Yeah. Okay, let me let's go to Halloween Town, which is in this direction. This is a Halloween Town building. All of the towers have a end crystal fire lava on top of it, and except for the advancement building, all the towers are different, which was my plan. Over there's my castle. Made a few pathways. Let's follow the pathways. Let's see. This is one of my buildings from Halloween Town. Got a little signboard, whatever thingy, which I barely ever use. As most of the stuff is in Dutch, so I'm not gonna say what's on there. Even in Dutch I have a really bad spelling, so yeah, it's even worse than my English, I think. Let's eat something. This is my Halloween tree. I used actual trees as an example for the branches. And let's see, over here I got a furnace array designed by El Mango, I think it was. So you put some items up in here and then fuel in that, and all of the drops come out here, and everything gets sorted. Every furnace gets an item at the same time because of the redstone on the back. It works out really nice. In his video he had, I think, a 50 furnace long thing, machine or whatever. I think it's enough to have 8, since my world doesn't really need that many many of the fuels, yeah, the smelting to be done. Let's go into the tree. Got a little fog effect. There used to be four bats in here, but probably because of chunk updates or something, only one stayed here and the rest got deleted, I guess. Got a little mouth in here. And got a little mushroom farm in the tree. So I got a few of those small mushrooms. And this leads to a cave with all kinds of mobs. I'm planning on putting more in here. This is a invisible spider. I put this trapdoor in here so the skeleton that I was luring down didn't kill it by accident. The plan is actually to have it like this, so you can see it while you walk down here. This cave has loads of mobs that I captured the way they are. In here I got three of the minis. I'm still in 113 because of the current bugs that are in the game. Way in the beginning this world used to be on a server. So my end dimension for some reason didn't have the same end dimension, which is weird. I don't know why I started talking about this. Hey, I forgot a block there. Huh. Okay, let's fix that real quick. Oh, that's not the right one. Let's not do that. Let's pick this one. Okay, fixed it. Yay. Got a few drones here. But yeah, I was talking about the nether. Doesn't matter too much, I think. Let's just show you what I'm doing here, and then when I'm in the nether I can talk about the nether. Let's do that. This is my pufferfish pond. I have zombies with items in the hands in the walls. That's why they blow themselves up when they're close to the walls. I got a phantom in here. A dinner bone zombie up on the roof. I thought let's put him on the roof, otherwise it looks a bit weird. I got one of these guys from the mansion. The other ones are killed. They might join the raids otherwise. I don't know if this one will, otherwise I'm just gonna kill him. Got a villager zombie with the same armor as that guy. He doesn't want to show his face right now. And over here I got a little chicken jockey. Took a long time to get him, so I'm really happy that I finally got one of those. I'm leaving Mr. or Mrs. Phantom. Got a skeleton here too. Okay, let's get out of here. Yeah, while I'm walking here, the end dimension for some reason was a different one, but once I put this world into single player, I got my original end dimension. Nether dimension, whatever. I got loads of these flowers around here. I'm trying to make them custom. You can actually make these guys custom. If you have one of these flowers, you can put another flower against it and it will start growing as well. There is a chance, because of 113 I think, that they will break off, which is really annoying. Also, when you stop them from growing, for instance with a carpet, they will never turn completely purple, so you can, you have white flowers, which I think looks a lot better. Got two trapped Endermen. One day they just appeared underneath a tree. Well, this one first. So I put him in a boat and then used some pistons to push him with the boat into this place. So he will never die because of rain, because the rain can't fall like that. I also finally captured a spider jockey. Was a real pain to get him. I did try to make a video for that, which I never really made. Because, yes, I wasn't talking and just placing blocks, and yeah, it was a really bad video. I used leaves with a too wide area and with a roof on top of it with leaves. Because, yeah, if this guy climbs up like he does now, he will suffocate the skeleton. So that's why the glass is up there, to prevent the skeleton from dying. And yeah. let's see. This is my latest build. It's a really weird one. It's a... On the inside, it's a chorus food flower farm. And yeah, it's just a really weird building. I do like how the top turned out, but it's offset and yeah. It has sort of like a L shape. And I eventually managed to get the towers like that. Well, one tower, and the other one is not really a tower. It's just a floating floating crystal. And let's see, let's go to sleep again. Oh, can't. Yeah, when I trapped that spider, I made a little stone type biome here. Okay, I'm back. I had like a frog in my throat, if I'm saying that correctly. I was making some noises that you don't want to hear, I guess. So, yeah, I have these weird cave thingies, and Enderman keeps stealing my blocks. I got a little turtle habitat, I call it. These guys can't escape. There's about 5 or 6, and there should be about 5 swimming around here. Let's see. Let's get out of here. Let's show you the awesome chorus food farm that I made. It's such a small farm in such a big building. Yeah, it's really simple. You just take off the flower and then replant it again. But it's so small on the inside. It's so big on the outside. It's, yeah, really funny actually. Okay, so let's get, let's see, where do I want to go now? Let's go to sleep first. Okay, let's go to the castle. Did I forget anything around here? Oh, the advancement building. Let's go there first. And when I come back from the end dimension, I'm going to do a little flyover here. Flyby, flyover. However you want to call it. Let's go to the advancement building on the inside. So on the inside, I got 2 live shulkers. That one just opened. And one of these... Vindicators, I think, with a glass pane in his head so he can't see me. Got a trap and hidden staircase, which I made myself. I did look for one on YouTube, but I didn't like the one I found, so I made it completely flush with the floor as much as I can. Got a little bed in here. It spawned in here while I was building this tunnel, so I just gave it a name. All of the advancements that are currently in 113 I put in here. All of the items are named. We got Mr. Advancement. This guy I turned from a villager zombie into a villager for the advancement. I got all the discs in the world that are currently in the game. I made a skeleton shoot a creeper. When I was bored of the Meteor Crater project, which I will show, yeah, in a little bit of time. So I shot one of the guys, one of the creepers. If he survived, because yeah, the bow is pretty strong. When he survived, I made a skeleton shoot him by walking in front of him like this, just avoiding the arrows. And yeah, that's how I got all the discs. Took me around 30 attempts. This is the hired help, number two actually, because the first one didn't want to help with walking in here, so I just killed him and put another one in here. A little hidden door here. This leads to a little cave, just a little one. It's a natural cave that I first filled up halfway up until here-ish. And then I thought, let's make it into a cave. So I made it into a cave. So I cleared out all the blocks again. Yeah. Let's see. In here I got a little mycelium farm. That's it. Let's see. Zombie. Yet everything except for the tree is spawn proof. So, yeah. Oh yeah, I got a charge creeper on the nose of the tree. Because of most of the time while I was still building this, a creeper used to spawn on the nose and try to explode. Yeah, me and the train, of course. So, yeah. I added a little forest here. Once I update, I'm gonna put a campfire on this coal block. I don't think it will disappear. I don't think. But yeah, the coal is like, yeah, it actually burned some stuff, I guess. A little sheep farm to shear them, of course. Let's see. In here, I have a little mountain with my cow farm. Apparently I left them jumping, which isn't a bad thing actually, because I need to breed some new ones. So I made this myself. So once you press this button, the cows get first burned, then suffocated by the block that the fire was on. And then everything goes in here, which is nice. And then I can breed them up here again. And the small cows all end up in here, as you can see. Let's breed up a few more and then go continue the tour. Otherwise I use the flint that I used to make the fire. If I only use it for two cows. Yeah. Okay, let's see. I think, yeah, I have got a building up here too. Give me a little bit of time. This is kind of weird, building, but yeah, most of my buildings are weird. I made, what's that? I made a house with a small tower on top of it and a little balcony. It's the first time I tried do something like this, and it turned out pretty okay, I guess. So yeah, like I said for the other ones, no interior whatsoever. This leads into the tower. There's an actual area here where you could sleep, but there's no beds. Yeah, this should be spawn proof. Yeah, this. Okay, let's go back down. Okay, a little balcony here. I think it turned out okay for my first attempt. Close the door. Okay. This is my castle. Yeah, quite a lot of work. And let's go down. An original village that spawned in 1.8, I think I made the world, maybe 1.7, but probably 1.8. Yeah, I got a little fire temple here. If you slap off the stairs so the fire can't be next to it, the logs won't burn. So if you have like a slab on each side of a wood log, it won't burn. That's how that works. Because yeah, the fire takes on this world. There's a little cave that leads to my pumpkin farm. I got the idea from Exumavoid. He made a video in about a pumpkin machine. I did ask him if he was gonna make a farm video for that. He said probably not, so I designed it myself. I made a video on my channel for this farm. If you want to build it yourself, it's pretty easy. I think I made it a little bit smaller than he did as well. But yeah, this is how it works. In my video, I have water all around this, but I wanted to make it look good, so I didn't put the water in here, so I just have to collect the stuff manually. Let's see there. Is that all of them? Around 50? That's almost 50. So it could be correct. Okay. Yeah. Oh well, if I'm missing a few, that's too bad. Oh, hi. Okay, never mind. Got one. I'm still missing one. Where is it? Where is it? But yeah, if you want to know how that works, I got a video for that on my channel. It's a pretty simple farm. It uses barely any redstone. I need to check if there's a mob inside of the tree. It's not spawn proof. Okay. This is my first mountain, Mount Ever. This is Mount Draco. Mount Ever is over there, which I will show once I come back from the end. My first dead tree. And yeah, that one is the second one. Let's see. Got some lava pits around here too, some random lava pits. I have a mill, a barn, and just a random tower. It's also done so it doesn't burn the wood. Just because I can do it, I guess. I don't know. Oh, my Halloween portal. And let's go this way into the castle. So in 1.13 the iron farm won't work anymore that I built in the castle. This is one of the barns as well. Let's go this way. In here I got the iron farm that I was talking about. It's just the simplest one you could make before 1.14. Over here I got a netherwart farm, a very big one, and over here I got Ifo's food farm. I made an adjustment to it so it will work in 1.13. I haven't tested it in 1.14, but yeah, I added a piston, a block and a little bit of redstone here. So it still works in 1.13, and a little clock for when I want to do it while I'm watching a video or something. I'm currently out of bone meal. This is a tree farm I made, my version 2 tree farm. It's just very simple. You plant the trees there, they grow, you chop them down, and the water will push everything in the hoppers. This is the inside. But yeah, I haven't used this in a long time because I don't really need the wood right now. Got a little skull here. Turned out okay for my first attempt, I think. Come on, let me out of here. Let's see. Yeah, there's supposed to be a endermite in here, but because of chunk problems it sometimes is invisible. As you can hear, it's still in here. It's sometimes invisible, sometimes it dupes itself, and sometimes there's just one in there. So yeah, got a big map of the area. This is Mount Ever. Up here I got a creeper farm, a charged creeper farm. And in the inside of the mountain I built a ant city. And yeah, that's the rest of the area. You can't see this where the tree is because that's what I'm working on currently. Let's see. Yeah, this leads to a skeleton spawner, which I don't use anymore. For some reason, I carved this out really big. I wanted to do something with the tunnel, but I never use it anymore, so I don't feel like doing that right now. Over here, this is my Scorpion King project. I cleared out a water temple, built a forest around it, and then I was planning on building a desert around it, but I never really finished that. I got the idea from the movie The Mummy. There was a guy which made a deal with a god and then got betrayed by that god and locked up in a pyramid with a jungle around it. That's kind of how it worked. This is my end dimension. Got a dragon sketch. I can't talk. A dragon skeleton. A huge circle in the middle. And yeah. And the pathway leading to my Enderman farm. Yeah. I also have a separate video for me doing this. Except for the carpets, everything. Well, it is still in my in survival. There's this glitch in 1.13. I don't think it works in 1.14 anymore, where you can duplicate carpets. I duped all of the carpets that I put on the Ant Island because it was too much work otherwise to get them legitimately. I think is how you say it. I used a lot of random. Can I zoom in? Oh, that's really weird. Like this maybe. I used a lot of random patterns. Turned out really okay, I think. The rarest item that I have in the world, which is this helmet. It has a -1 durability. -1. I got this during a live stream. A skeleton was annoying me while I was building the custom river. Let's see, he was annoying me. I shot him, and at the second he died, his helmet broke, and that's how that turned into a -1 helmet. Loads of bulk storage. My villager killing machine, which is obsolete because in the next update you can just make the village into whatever you want. But yeah, it was a lot of fun to make this. It has 4 different ways of killing a villager. I added some clocks and yeah, all kinds of randomization stuff. This item gives out 2 signals, this gives out 1, and that randomly selects one of these 2, and then these do the same. Yeah, I can't really explain redstone all that well. All of these guys I'm going to try to upgrade, get them in 1.14 to actually trade with me still, if that makes sense. I can sometimes not find the words. Sometimes I cannot find words. Nothing special, just storage place, just a storage place. Accents a shitter. His youngest daughter Amy and his oldest daughter Anastasia. Down here I got my let's go this way first. I got a slime farm, which is this area. There's iron golems in the walls, which the slimes get attracted to. And then they fall to their deaths onto the cactus. If they don't fall on the cactus, they just get killed by the cactus with water streams. And yeah, I got an elevator here which keeps breaking because I don't know. Yeah, there's loads of slime balls. Let's go back. In here, somewhere. Oh, the elevator that I never use anymore. This can send up two items at a time. Because there's two thingies. They probably are obsolete because of the water streams too, but whatever. Over here I got a cactus farm behind the wall. I think there's about maybe 4 or 8 cactuses behind there or something. A little donation tunnel, like fire and lava. Yeah, just very simple. This is that's not good. Hi. This is this is Impulse his pumpkin farm. I added a button. For some reason this kept locking up when I left the chunks and the pumpkin would grow. What the? Is that glitched out? Huh. That flower is glitched. That's weird. Huh. For some reason it would lock up when a flower would grow. Let's see, when a flower would, well, flower, a pumpkin would grow. So I added a wave effect. Oh, now it's normal again. Well. So to add this button. So now it gets a wave effect. But then I can reset it. I got a repeater on behind all of these machines. So, yeah. I made a small pumpkin carving machine. So when you want to carve some pumpkins, you can do that. I also made a video for this. This is a lot faster machine made by El Mango or something. I think El Mango. Yeah. But yeah, if you want to know how the simple version works that I made, I think it's the other way around. No. Then yeah, this is the fastest it can go. But yeah, if you want the faster one, you can watch El Mango's video. I also made a video for this machine, by the way. It's on my channel. Yeah, it's just a simple farm. Let's see, let's go up here. Okay, loads of shulker boxes. Got even more somewhere. all filled with stone or cobblestone. A little automatic furnace, which also no longer works because I don't really chop any trees down anymore. I think I sawed birch and jungle trees, which will get turned into coal with this machine. But yeah, as long as I don't use the tree farm, it doesn't work. So yeah, this is how the pistons work for the pushing of the dirt. This is my second version. On the back side it looks like this, and that's all you need. Yeah, it's the middle one. If you want to rebuild it, you could probably tell from just watching this video. Let's go to the next thingy. I was trying to lock this elevator from working with a minecart or something, but it doesn't want to work. I need to probably power this one or whatever, I don't know, or maybe the hopper or something. I don't know, I was trying to make it lock, because when I leave the chunks I have to take that one item out of here. Let's see, let's go this way, let's go to the next layer. Well, the third layer actually. No, well, I don't know. Let's go all the way up. Let's just say that. So this leads to my sugarcane farm, which is really inefficient. But I build it for looks, not efficiency. Once this activates, or actually deactivates, the water will flow out of the sides, which just happened. and then everything gets flooded into there, into my storage. Let's throw that in there. Okay. Yeah, I do have an on and off, but I never use it. And here you can see the cages for the villagers. This probably will break as well. This guy harvests the crops. He stands, he walks here and thinks he can give these guys carrots, but there's blocks in front of them, but he still could see him. And the hoppers will steal all of the food from him. That's how that works. And on the inside here is the iron farm. On the first one, it's probably the same glitch as the Endermite. So he just died. He's on when he walked over a chunk border or something, or it got deleted. I tried to replace him once, but yeah, he also got deleted. So yeah, let's see. This is on top of the iron farm. This is what I did with this area. Let's go up here. This is the roof of the tree farm. It's the roof for the netherwood farm. A really bad one for the iron farm. The staircase one. The sugarcane one. That small house, I got the idea from TangoTech. He made a little house on the Hermitcraft server, and I liked how he did it, but I used a lot more blocks to make it look like it looks now. And yeah, I think mine looks good too. And I put two of them on the sides of my castle. Yeah, and this is the custom river. Let's see, I got only 3 rockets, that's not a lot. See how far I can get without rockets, without actually putting the elytras on. Yeah, it's a good thing I got feather falling. Yeah, I put coarse dirt down here. For some reason, the grass kept growing down. It was a real pain to get all of the grass out of the water again. But yeah, what can you do? This is the backside of the castle. That tower, I got the idea from what's the guy's name again? Gerocraft. Way in the beginning, when he was making smaller buildings and stuff, he made a small house, a small tower, with 1, 2, 3 towers attached to it and a roof. I made mine a little bit bigger, as you can see. This is my version of his tower, and mine is also connected to another build, so I can't build all the houses on all sides like he did. But I think it turned out really nice. Over here we got Gareth, the Angel of Death, someone who also streams on Twitch. He sometimes is in my streams. Yeah, I built a statue for his guy. I give him wings. Yeah, turned out okay. Let's see. I need to quickly make some rockets. I forgot about that. I'm completely out of rockets. Let's go and get some paper. Okay, I got some rockets. This is my meteor crater. In the middle of the map, there's a end portal. So the idea for this area is a meteor crashed into the world. It made the end dimension, and the end dimension is trying to escape to the overworld. That's where the yellow stuff all is. It's completely filled in on the back. And yeah, I didn't really put too much effort into that on the backside, just cover it up, I guess. Let's go to my train station. Okay, so this is my train station. It's not completely smog proof, as you can see. I have a big window out here so you can look into the nether. And let's go to the Wither Skeleton Farm. This is how this area looks. Just a really big tunnel, I guess. Took a long time to make. Okay, and this is the this is the Wither Skeleton Farm. The top level is only for ghasts, so you can kill some ghasts, get some tears. And yeah, loads of pushers that push the mobs down. And that's it. I recently made it AFK ball. It doesn't kill the withers, it just kills everything else. Let's see, let's go this way. So I made it AFK cable that will activate the crushers there, but yeah, I don't really use the AFK function unless I'm going up there to kill a ghast or down below to sort some stuff in this chest. I can manually push the mobs into the middle and then I don't have to move from the spot and just kill them, then do that again and then they can get pushed back in. I also got a pushing system for this level that push first, they fall down, and then another one over there pushes them in here. Yeah, I'm not so good at explaining stuff. Yeah, let's go back with the minecart. Okay, then let's go to the end dimension, which is this way. I think this one leads to the tiger biome. There's only a tree farm there. There's nothing special, just for the big trees and the mycelium. This one, I'm not sure. This, yeah, nothing special. I think the mesa and something else. Don't know. But this tunnel leads to my end dimension. Let's go there. I'm not so good with this jumping stuff. It really doesn't work when I do it. Let's go in here. In here I got a little bit more of a mob collection. This guy actually spawned in with diamond armor. It's really rare that they spawn in like that. And yeah, this almost at the end of this area that when he spawned in, I used about four beacons to build this area. This is the meteor crater. Let's put the elytra on. Do a little flyby. Now I have rockets. Yeah, everything here was removed with an axe and a beacon. Took really long time. But yeah, I have a lot of stone now, so I can build a lot of stuff. Yeah. I did this just because. Is that an iron skeleton? Oh, it's a chainmail skeleton. Let's escape. Yeah, nothing is lit up here. Yeah, this is about the only place where mobs can still spawn because of the carpets. This leads to my enderman farm. It's nothing special. Just a long tunnel. I really don't like building in the end dimension, because in the overworld, if you die, you can still get some, have a chance of getting your drops back. But when you die here, you just lose everything when you fall in the void. Yeah, there's nothing special, just an Enderman farm. I got the enchanting thing here too. This guy is named. I'm not gonna look at him. Yeah. It's with an Endermite. Okay, let's go to the let's go to the island. And yeah, then I'm gonna do a little flyby of the overworld after this. And oh hi, yeah, that's as far as I know, this is the only place they can still spawn. Yeah, so this is the dragon. It turned out pretty okay for my first dragon skeleton. I have some wool as eyes, and yeah, the mouth, got the neck. This is a wing, obviously. Yes, yes. And it should, this arrow should be completely spawn proof. Got a tail and some feet. Yeah, let's go to the overworld, do a little flyby. And that's probably I think I showed everything when I did the flyby, except for the ant city. Let's see, it's nighttime. Let's go to sleep again. Because, yeah, the mountain isn't mob-proof either. So, yeah. Where I built the entrance, there used to be normal stone, and yeah, a creeper blew it up, and eventually I thought, let's build an ant city inside of it, so I made the entrance where the creeper blew up. Yeah, so okay, let me put the render distance a bit higher. This is also something that happens in my world. When I go into the end or nether, it unlocks itself, which will no longer happen in 1.14. I already tested that, which is nice. It's really annoying. I don't want to by accident turn this into peaceful or whatever and lose all my mobs. Oh, that's too much. That's more than enough. This is my Mount Ever, once it loads in, of course. Like I said, on the inside is an ant city. On the top is a creeper farm, charge creeper farm. I'm always trying to escape from the lightning because, yeah, I don't have the fire tick off. I don't want my tree to burn down, which happened once before. So I was really happy that I had a save game and I didn't do too much in the live stream. Half of the face was completely gone. Not just the face, the complete half of the tree was gone, which is really annoying. and the pearls. Okay, go up there. Okay, got a vertical portal in here with just a little opening, like so. Okay. Oh, the first thing that I'm gonna do when I stop recording is kill that fly. It keeps annoying me. I got a boat at the city. It's exact duplicate of an actual city, except for the light sources, of course. That one is offset by one block, and the boat needs to be offset a few blocks to the left and about 10 blocks further out, but then this area would have had to be even bigger, so I didn't really want to do that. I think there was about 40k black blocks to get all of this filled in. It looks a lot better with the black blocks. All of my elytras are in the boat, so if I ever lose this set, I need to go back in there, which is doable. I just need to stack up there with some blocks, and then yeah, then I can get the blocks back, I guess. The stack that never got used. Yeah, I made one stack too many of the black blocks, so yeah, 40k black blocks, that's a lot. Let's do a little flyby, I guess. Can I ascend like that, get up like this? No, I can't. Not so good at getting up like that. So yeah, this is the Ant City. Yeah, it's more or less mob proof on the floor as well. Ouch. It's more or less mob proof on the floor. I haven't seen any mobs in here yet, so when I was showing this in stream. Let's go get out of here again. Okay. Let's do a little flyby. Don't think I have to. Yeah, there's not really a lot to see with the creeper farm, how that works. So I'm not going to show that. Made a little sandstone river here. This is the Ant City. Ant City, the the Halloween town. That's my dragon statue. Custom trees, loads of them. Yeah, let me know in the comments below what you think of this world. And if you are still watching, thank you for that. And maybe until next time. So yeah, that's probably all of the stuff that I have built in this world, which is quite a lot. Quite a lot of work for 5 years, I guess. Yeah. But yeah, thank you for watching, and maybe until next time. Bye.